Hi, this is Marshall Jones, and if you already know why Schramm's communications model is important to the field of learning, design, and technology, then you can watch this video and go, yep, that's right. If not, you're in for a treat. Sure, Schramm's model has been around for quite some time, but it still has a lot of relevance today. Schramm's model is what helps us to articulate what happens in communication, and that's important to us when we're designing learning environments because we are communicating to learners, and this is going to help you understand some of the things you should be considering. So let's get started. Communication starts with the sender. That is the person who initiates the communication. In this case, that's me. I am encoding the communication into spoken and written English with some visual signals. So encoding means that it gets encoded into some format to be transmitted as a signal. Now, that signal is then going to be received over here by the receiver, that's you. But in order to receive that, you have to decode that, which means that you have to be able to understand written and spoken English and understand these visuals as they are presented to you. Assuming all that happens, then it makes it to the receiver. So, what I need as the sender is I need some feedback from the receiver on how that message was received. Was it received successfully? If so, in a classroom, I might see people nodding their heads in agreement. In a format like this, I might see likes to a video. I might receive an asynchronous email from you that you understood. However, feedback can also be negative, that even though the signal was received, that it wasn't understood. You've seen this in classrooms where people look at you quizzically. You may see it asynchronously through some of the same channels, through questions that may show up in email or some sort of asynchronous communication model. Now, Schramm's communication model accounts for something that happens to the signal, and that is noise. And noise in Schramm's model is anything that impacts the signal. That noise can certainly be auditory. It could be airplanes flying overhead. It could be the hum of an air conditioner, the buzzing of a fluorescent light. But in Schramm's model, communication could be interrupted by noise that may not be auditory. For example, the way that you feel could impact your ability to receive the signal. If you're hungry, if you're tired, if you're cold, if you're cranky, all of these things can impact the signal. The noise can be something that happens within the environment. Is the room too hot? Is the room too cold? Is the room too dirty? Does the room smell bad? All of these things are things that could impact the signal. The other thing that's very important in Schramm's model is overlapping fields of experience between the sender and the receiver. So if you look in those overlapping fields of experience, that's where the signal is. So for that signal to make it successfully to the receiver, it needs to be within a shared field of experience. Let me give you an example. If I were to say to you, the note was sour because the seam was split, my bet is you know exactly what all of those words mean individually, but collectively, unless you've heard this example before, or unless you're a bagpipe player, you may not understand what that means. A split seam would mean that the bag itself is not holding air properly and it's impacting the sound. So why is this relevant to learning? When we choose examples for our learners, it's important that those examples are ones that can be understood by both the sender and the receiver. You've probably experienced this. You've probably been in a class where a professor makes a reference to a television show that perhaps they watched when they were growing up, but you did not watch. If our understandings of popular culture are different, then we can have problems with our field of experience. But that field of experience is impacted by a number of things. It could be impacted culturally. If the sender and the receiver are from different cultures, then it's possible that examples could be used that are not understood because of cultural differences and perhaps cultural biases. Fields of experience can also be separated by things like socioeconomic status, the geographic region of the country you might live in, and a number of other things. Schramm's model is important to us in learning design and technology because by articulating the way that communication happens, it helps us to control for certain things to make our learning environments better. For example, being able to anticipate what noise might impact a signal can help us not necessarily to eliminate the noise, but perhaps to control for it in some way. Understanding that our examples have to have relevance to both parties means that we do a careful analysis of who our learners are so that we have a better idea of what our instruction may be able to do to bridge both fields of experience. I'm Marshall Jones. Thanks for watching.